Hello everyone, I, Ms. Bhavna Dhanesh Munod, welcome you all in Agricultural Development Trust Shardabai Pawar Mahila Arts, Commerce and Science College, Shardanagar, Baramati.
So last period we studied children regarding top level management, middle level management and lower level management, and we studied also about their functions, the work of top level management, the work of middle level management and the work of lower level management. Now let us see what is the next point in your chapter. So the next point is related to discussion. If we are in a group, so let us discuss whether management is an art, whether management is a science, or management is a profession. So the question may come like this. Long answer question, 10 marks it will be. Explain whether management is an art, or management is a science, or management is a profession, children. So we'll see what they have told us. First, we have seen in the definition that management is universal in nature. As I told you about galaxy, how galaxy is managed, how solar system is managed. So universal in nature. It exists everywhere. It is an intangible. We have seen function. We cannot see it, but it is managed everywhere. So management is an inherent part of every type of organization. So on this context, it is said that without effective management, it is very difficult to achieve any goal. It is very difficult to decide also the nature of management, whatever changes are there, whatever change in direction is there, whatever things are there, change. It is very difficult for effective management. So management is different from different dimensions. Any angle we see, we will find management difficult. So it will be different also. Every angle management will have different point of view. Therefore, it is very essential to study about management separately from this all three dimensions, which are as follows. So we will study management as an art, we'll study management as a science, and we'll study management, children, as a profession. So let us see why we have to study from all the three dimensions, because we have to understand what management is. Till now, what we studied in definition, that management is an art. We have to let people think done. Whatever work is there, it is an art from the people how the work will be completed. So that we studied as management. Management also we studied in other part of definition. It is to coordinate, to control. So here, according to three different levels, three different dimensions, that is art, science and profession, we have to study management. Why we have to study? Because management will be applied different in different communications. In different organizations, management may be different. We cannot see it, children. It is intangible. But management is applied everywhere, in every field, in everywhere, in any organization. Why? To get effective result. Now, for example, in a day-to-day life also, what we do, children, we have things planned, we manage it. Now suppose I have decided to wake up at 5 o'clock, complete my work, 7 o'clock I will go to school, then after school, that is 2 o'clock, if my school gets over, then 3 to 4 I will play, after 4 to 6 I will study, 6 to 8 I will watch TV, and 8 to 9 I will have dinner, and after dinner I will go for sleep. What is this? Your whole day routine. For example, I'm telling about a student, a whole day routine. So the thing is, when the student follow this time, he manages everything on time, then the task will be completed. But if I told my target is to get up at 5 o'clock, but if I am lazy and I get up at 7 o'clock, all the things will be late. That means I did not work, I did not manage properly my discipline, my work, and so whatever the results were there, it were not satisfied. So when you manage things on time, the work and task is completed and you get effective results, children. So let us see what is management according to art section. So management as an art. Now, art is what, children? It is bringing about a desired result through application of skills. Now, people having talent, art is what? Skills, talent. So people having skills, talent, that is called as art. You know, an art is an creative ability. and innovativeness means new ideas, new skills people introduced. So it is a creative type of person. Innovativeness, any person is having new ideas. Now suppose, for example, a child is very good in painting, children. Very good. He innovates new ideas, new these things. New type of drawing is there. So what we call innovativeness in drawing. Now, for example, if I tell about Rangoli. Now, from olden days, if you have observed, Rangoli was dotted type. I'm just giving an example about Rangoli, children. Rangoli, what we use in Diwali. So that was of dotted time in olden days. Now see how many different types of Rangoli has become. It is freehand design. It is Rangoli underwater. Then they have also sketches in drawing in Rangoli, children. So much change in that Rangoli pattern. You also observe. So much change in design. So much patterns are there. So why we call Rangoli as an art? Anyone cannot draw Rangoli. Anyone are not experts in drawing Rangoli. So Rangoli is what? An innovativeness of a person. Creativity. So if a person has skill, talent, interested, he can put better Rangolis. Better art. Now, this art is an inborn talent, say. From childhood, if the child is having an hobby, from childhood is very good in drawing. So he will be very good in Rangoli also. He will be an artist. So it depends upon childhood, inborn talent or quality of a person. Your talent depends. So that inborn talent also, and with proper education and training, children, you can develop qualities in yourself. That is called as an art. So that quality may be of singing, dancing, acting, sports, drawing, skating, cycling, horse riding, movies, musician, magician, etc. Anytime, anything related to innovativeness, creativity, that is called as art. So that is developed if you have proper training. Even we have, for example, horse riding training, acting courses are there, acting schools is there, dance teacher is there, singing teacher is there. Why these are there? To train ourselves, to make us more better, to make us more effective. So we have to have training of these things. So if childhood we have a hobby of singing and you get proper training, children, you can be a good singer in future. So in short, an art is defined as what? Performance of inborn quality or skill in which there is no compulsion of having, say, educational qualification. See, an artist person, it is not compulsory to have a degree. Any artist person, it will be a singer, dancer, we don't ask them the educational qualification. Now, for example, singer is there. Say, Lata Mangeshkar, Asha Bhosle. Why we recognize them? Why we know them? Because of their talent singing. Did we anytime ask what the Asha Bhosle is, how much she is educated, or Sri Lata Mangeshkar, how much she is educated? We have never asked her their educational qualification. But we know them by their talent, children. Even actors. Whoever actors will be there, suppose Amitabh Bachchan. Why we know him? Because of his talent, because of his acting in movies. We know persons. So why we know them? Because of their skills, their talent, and we didn't ask them their qualification anytime, how much they are educated. We know them, they are famous because of their skills, their talent, and this is called as an art, children. So the result of art may be different from person to person, though they perform with the same quality or skill, but results will be different. So that is the reason they have told, they have given an example that every female singer cannot perform like Asha Bhosle, or every cricket player cannot perform like Sachin Tendulkar. Now see, children, again I am repeating this point. Now what they have told, now every singer, there are many singers, see, same profession is there, many singers are there, like Asha Bhosle is there, Lata Mangeshkar is there, then Sunidhi Chauhan is there latest. So, but these have their own voice, their own talent. We cannot compare their voices. Every singer cannot be, they have told, like Asha Bhosle. And every cricketer will be not playing like Sachin Tendulkar or like performing like Sachin Tendulkar. They have created their own talent, skills, developed. They manage themselves very nicely and they got effective result. Whatever the result is there because of their hard work and dedication. Even we can say about Amitabh Bachchan, no actor will be compared with him. We call them as the legendary actor, because no one can copy and no one can copy his voice also. We know him. So this is what that every actor also cannot be considered as Amitabh Bachchan over here. So this is the reason that art is what? Bringing about a desired result.